Crow Hill. I like the Moto track. I like the fast start. You know, there's some dangerous rocks out there in high speed sections, so that's a little sketchy, but you know, it's the same for everybody, and all around it's a really great track, and the ram track section's awesome, the extreme section's awesome, it's all awesome.
Alright Kyle, so we're here, it's Crow Hill, Crow Hill 2, it's a loud fuel Crow Hill 2. This is your, what is it, 12th race of the season?
Yep.
It's a beautiful day. How do you feel about today's race?
Yeah, it is a beautiful day here at Crow Hill. Feeling good today.
How could you not? Yeah, how could you not feel good? It's beautiful. So, coming into the race, you had kind of a rough sleep work schedule. Tell me a little bit about your schedule this week and how you prepared to be awake and ready to race today.
Yeah, this week was tough. I worked Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday night, and then Thursday night we did a supercross at the Rochester Fair.
And you won that.
I won that. It was good. Great night.
Yeah.
Good time. And so I took Thursday night off work, took Friday night off work, and Saturday got everything ready, and actually got some good sleep.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, you're well prepared. More well prepared than normal.
More than normal.
Sleep wise, yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
So
good luck today. Have an awesome race.
Thanks, man.
We'll talk to you after the race.
Sounds good.
All right. Thanks, bud.
Mm-hmm. get him, Ken. Dude, the bike was fucking mint. And I rode my hardest. Chicken. He beat me straight up. Like, I felt awesome.
Hey,
I felt so good, dude. This is crazy.
On the edge faster.
Yeah, the whole time.
You must have gotten a pretty good show.
Yeah? Oh yeah. It's crazy.
I mean, did you just see shit where you're like, how did he not go down?
He hit that the whole time. It's crazy. Oh, it's fucked up. I'm like, I couldn't believe he caught up to me. I'm like, I had a pretty good gap. All of a sudden, he's on me. Case scenario, I got a second.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Yep. So everything felt good, he just...
Yeah. The bike felt fucking awesome, like perfect.
Went really good. Johnny got the hole shot, and I got by him soon after that. I think I led for about 2 laps, and I felt awesome out there. The bike was perfect, yeah. And I had a pretty good gap on him, and I thought I was good, and come to a mud section, and all of a sudden he was on me.
Yeah.
I think he was going faster through the tighter stuff. He ended up getting by me, and kind of followed right behind him for a while. He was hanging it out on the ragged edge, and I thought I was going fast, but I was able to stay with him for a while, and you know, some lappers got in the way, and he ended up pulling away a little bit, so I ended up second, but I tried my hardest, man. I felt really good. The track was good.
Awesome.
Just hope for next moto.
Yeah, next moto.
Yep.
Are you gonna make any changes to the bike for the next moto?
I think I might leave it, maybe just soften the front a little bit. Uh-huh. Other than that, it felt awesome.
Yep. Had all the lines you needed. And
I had a bunch of good lines, but I think we're gonna have to switch them up for the last moto. Yeah. It's gonna be rough.
How are you feeling physically?
So far, so good.
Nice.
I feel like I'm just getting warmed up.
All right, good, that's what you want.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks a lot, buddy.
He said, you are crazy fast out there.
Yeah.
You are crazy fast. You are on the razor's edge of out of control.
Yeah.
You can't catch him. So tell me about it out there. How was it? How'd you feel?
You know, I felt good. I was a little pumped up, but the track was good, and it's definitely gnarly, and you gotta, you know, pick good lines, and you know, I think it's just all about, you know, strategy about picking the lines and getting through the stuff clean, and you know, keeping the momentum where you can.
Okay. He had the whole shot.
Yeah.
And he quickly caught you in the moto section.
Yeah. Yeah, I was jacked up definitely off the start, and he was ripping, and he, you know, he got around me definitely, and it was a good battle the first couple laps. He pulled away a little bit, and I reeled him back in, and I actually got him in the deep mud hole, and coming out of it, and it was a good race.
Yeah. So are you going to make any changes to your bike for the second, or you're going to ride it just like
no,
it is?
I'm going to leave it the way it is. It seems to be working good, and we'll go for it again.
All right.
Cool.
Good luck, man.